Hello everyone, welcome to Straight Bat with Gulf News and Mr. Cricket UAE, that is Anish Sargent. Tonight we will discuss CSK's match with Delhi Capitals. Before we start, let's get the ball rolling with Anish Sargent.
Thank you, Shyam. Hi, Satish. Hello, disappointed Arjan. But, you know, to be very honest, I was privileged to watch one of the finest games. The match was heading towards Delhi, and then you have to say salute to Lord Thakur who brought them back into the game. But it is Sri, another Lord Gautam handed over it on the platter back to Delhi. Because he was sold for 10 crore. Yeah. That's why I called him Lord Gautam.
Yes, before I get to the technical part with Satish, Arjun, what are your exact feelings right now?
To be honest, I'm feeling kind of sleepy. I woke up at 4 a.m. and I'm so tired.
But did you enjoy the match?
Yeah, of course I did. It was a very, like, it always flip side. You never knew who was going to win. But I think the major thing was Gautam dropping that catch and it went for a 4. I think also Dhawan, who's actually challenging the BCCI's decision to not put him in the T20 squad. I actually think Gautam did the big oopsie there by dropping Shemron Hetmyer and also letting it go for a 4.
Satish, how do you assess the match? It was a perfect T20 match. I mean,
so, yeah, there were lots of ups and downs, Shyam, twists and turns, as any T20 or IPL match would do. But there are some positives, which both from the Chennai side as well as the Delhi side, I could see as they go on. Like, yeah, of course, this 2 points would have helped the cement the number one slot. But that was not to be. Delhi took that, which is good for them. Number one, Chennai was getting a good start with Rituraj, and today, without the openers giving a start, they managed to score 136. Could have gone a little further ahead if probably somebody like Robin Uthappa or Moeen Ali, you know, like gave that little extra start. That would have helped, actually. Another 10-15 runs would have been a match-winning total then. Of course, I think during the break or one of the talk shows, even Shreyas Iyer said 150 will be a winning total. So, wicket was not as easy as looking at initially. But that's a positive from Chennai side. They were exposed to the middle order. Dhoni got some runs. Raidu was in good form. He played a very nice knock, like getting singles and punishing the loose balls. It was a good the performance from Chennai per se. Then from the Delhi point of view, the bowling once again showed that they have a very good all-round bowling team, which can adapt to any situation. And they did excellent in the final overs with Avesh Khan giving away probably one or a couple of runs only. So that six or two sixes would have made a big difference in the final total. That over made that it was under 140, which didn't go over 136 for the final score. And then from the batting point of view of Delhi, Dhawan getting some runs is also good for them. So there are a lot of positives going forward.
Satish, you have said everything now. I don't have any questions to ask. You answered all the questions.
That's true, Shyam. Now we can talk about the points table, how it goes from here.
Okay, let me ask you one thing. Did the Dhoni miss a trick by not bringing up Jadeja or Bravo instead of him coming on?
100%, Shyam. I was about to say that. But generally, my communication is a short, so I said it's the second part. I'll be very honest, Dhoni had to do the consolidation job, but he looks totally out of touch. He doesn't look the batsman which we used to see until 2019. It's seen the pandemic has caught up with him, and he looks a batsman of not the same like we used to see. And he slowed down the game so much. And after you have got set, you need to up the tempo. And then you get out. You can't expect Jadeja's to come and do miracles every time. He definitely missed the trick.
Arjun, I know you're a Dhoni fan. Do you agree with that? Especially because we have seen in the first match against Mumbai how Bravo took away the match from them with an 8-ball knock. We have seen Jadeja pull them out and maybe they would have helped. Do you agree?
Yeah, you know, Dhoni, I'm a fan of his, but sometimes he doesn't play that well. Like today, he could have brought in someone who can score runs quicker. Dhoni needs to get back in form. He needs to up his strike rate. I mean, you can't get like 100 strike rate and be okay with it. It's a T20. It's not like a test or anything. He needs to make sure that he hits sixes like he used to and he makes the crowd proud.
Satish, I'm not going to ask you any questions if you're giving me 2-minute answers.
No. No, go ahead. One liner. Okay.
Yeah. What happens now? What happens with Delhi finishing on top? How does it matter now?
Yeah, see, Isham, it is also an important win for Delhi because Delhi will be playing Rajasthan, Bangalore Royal Challengers in their final game. So between RCB and Delhi, 1-2 points will be for only one team. So that way, that 2 points, who is going to get will be, you know, like up for grabs there. And I think if Chennai wins the next game as well, and Bangalore go on to win the next, they have 2 games in hand. So if Bangalore go on to win the next game and the final game against Delhi, there will be a three-way tie for the with 20 points there. So the run rate could
basically
come in
we are looking at the other slots.
Yeah, the other slots, I think tomorrow will set a nice trend for how it's going to go. But I would still, today, I will toe your line. Between Rajasthan and Mumbai, I will go with Mumbai.
Okay, before quickly coming to Anispa, let me ask you, Arjun, where do you see CSK go from here?
You know, now that they're number two, I think RCB is going to be a slight problem. But I'm pretty sure they can score 22 points and just get away with it.
Before we wind up, Anis Pai, your last thoughts on today's match and we shall wind up with that.
Well, I'm afraid CSK lost a golden opportunity to seal a spot in the top. And if they go on to lose the last match, which is against Punjab, which I believe they will win. But if they go on to lose the last match, they might come at number three and then they play the eliminator. So it's danger for CSK. So they have to ensure they win the last match. And as Satish said, if 3 teams come on 20 points, then there will be the net run rate. So far, CSK's net run rate is good. So hope for the best. My yellow jacket didn't work today. Style one with the blue jacket.
I think you need to bring that back now.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's all from us today. Thank you very much for watching.
Thank you.
Please log on to gatsnews.com for more updates and all our social media channels for more news. Thank you very much.